Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. Today we're going to be creating a Viking Avatar t-shirt design. In this tutorial, we'll look at how you can create out a vector avatar from sketch using Illustrator. During the process, I'll be using some vector resources from vixels.com. Under Vixel, you can download the vectors in several formats. They offer monthly subscriptions starting at $9.99 with licenses for every download. They also have subscriptions for merch sellers, where you can download their print-ready designs and use their graphics on your shops. You can also create out any designs you want with their resources. For subscribers, they also have design requests where you can ask for any designs you can't find and they will create them for you. So let's begin with the designing process. The first thing we're going to do is to trace out the sketch. So open a new Illustrator document. Now we'll drag in the JPEG image of the sketch inside Illustrator. Scale down the size and place it around here. Then lock the image using the shortcut Command or Control 2. This way it will not misplace the position. Now the first thing we're going to do is to trace out the sketch. So select the pen tool and start tracing out the beard. Click and drag to give the curve path. Click on this arrow icon to switch the color to stroke. Then continue tracing all the outlines. Follow along the curves to give a pointed ends. After this, use die selection tool to adjust the anchor points. Adjust the handles to give smoother curves. Next, select the shape and apply fill color. Now to trace out the mouth region, let's reduce the opacity to 28%. Then trace out the lips area. After that, select both the shapes and apply minus friend option on the pathfinder. This will subtract out the lips area. Now edit the handles to give smoother curves using die selection tool. Next, we'll trace out the head region. So select the pen tool and trace out the cap. Then adjust the anchor points using the die selection tool. Click and drag the handles to adjust the curve path. In the same way, let's trace out the horn region. Follow along the sketch and adjust the handles. Trace out the second horn as well. Now select all the three shapes and apply fill color. Next, we'll trace out the nose. For this, we'll keep it open-ended. Let's extend the top end and adjust the curves to give round end. Adjust the anchor points according to the shape of the nose. Next, we'll create out the glass. So for that, I'll go to Vixel and look up for the vectors. Let's search for glasses. And let's download this vector. I'll also need Viking helmet. So let's look up for it and download it. Now let's open our downloaded vectors. This is the vector file. Let's open it in Illustrator. Now under Illustrator, you can see it is a pattern design. So select the pattern and go to Object and expand it. Now right click and ungroup it, then release the clipping mask. Now drag out the piece and then ungroup it and release clipping mask. Ungroup one more time. This will separate out all the vectors. Select the glass shape and drag and drop it to our main document. Place it above our sketch and scale on the size. Now change the fill color to something else. Next, we'll modify the shape according to our design. So selecting the shape, go to Object, Envelope Distort and apply Make with Mesh. Here set the columns to 2 and the rows to 1 and click OK. After that, using the die selection tool, start adjusting the anchor points to tweak the shape. Adjust the handles to match it according to our design. Keep on adjusting it until you get the desired look. Once done, go to Object and click on Expand. This will expand the shape into Fill Object. Next, double click on the shape. Again, double click one more time. Now select the inner shape and delete it out. Do the same for the other. Then double click outside. Next, select the beard and increase its opacity. Now we'll apply some color to your design. For the cap, we'll give bright yellow color. We'll be using this color code. So select the shape, double click on the fill color, apply the code and click OK. Arrange the second horn to the back. Using the shortcut Command or Control, open square bracket. For the glasses, apply dark gray color. For the nose, we'll give light skin color. We'll be using this color code. So select the nose, double click on the fill color, and apply the color. Let's create a shape for the face. Draw a shape on the back. We'll be using this color code. Next, we'll add shadow beside the nose. So select the nose and arrange it to front. Then using the pen tool, draw a curved shape like this. After that, pick the color using the eyedropper tool. Now we'll add shades to the face. For that, first select the background shape and create a duplicate on top using the shortcut Command or Control C to copy and Command or Control F to paste in front. Then using the pen tool, start drawing out a curved shape over the design. Follow along the nose and the face. Then complete the shape. Now select the shape and the background shape and apply minus front option on the pathfinder. For this, apply dark skin color. Use the color code hash A87C7B. Then arrange it to back. Let's create our under shape for the other side. It should have the same color. Then select both the shapes and combine them. Next, we'll add few more details over the nose. So select the pen tool and draw a shape over the nose. Arrange it to front, then adjust the handles to get a curve according to the shape of the nose. Then apply light skin color using the color code hash E9C3B8. Next, select the nose and create a duplicate on top. Then with the Alt pressed, click and drag it to create under duplicate. Place it around here, leaving a certain thickness. Then, using the die selection tool, edge the anchor points. Drag down the lower anchor points to give thinner strokes. After that, select the top shape and lower shape and apply minus front option on the pathfinder. Pick a darker color for the shape. Start tweaking the shapes to match the flow according to the nose. After this, draw out under curve shape at the corner. Select this shape and under duplicate of the nose shape and apply intersect option. This will leave us the overlapping portion. Give dark color to this shape. Next, draw a curve over the glasses. Give white stroke color. Draw out under stroke for the other side. Now select both the strokes and under stroke panel, change the profile to pointed ends. Next, we'll add the pointed details to the cap. To create these, select the cap and create a copy on top. Then using the pen tool, draw the pointed curve shape. After that, select the pointed curve shape and the cap and apply minus front option. Apply black color to this shape. We'll follow the same steps for the second pointed design. create duplicate of the cap shape on top. Then draw the pointed curve shape. Then select both the shape and apply minus front option. For this, we'll apply this color, use the color code hash B2B09A, then arrange it to back. Next, we'll add the beard shades. So select the pen tool and draw the zigzag shapes. Click and drag to give the curves and click on the anchor points to break the points. After that, select all the shapes, switch it to fill color. Adjust the size and the angle of rotation and apply light gray color using the color code hash 5E5C5D. Next, we'll add details to the horns. So, first reduce the opacity of all the shapes. Then, using the pen tool, trace out the sketch. Now, create a duplicate of the base shape. Then, select both the shapes and apply minus front option. Draw out on the shape and adjust it according to the design. Next, reduce the opacity of the second horn and trace out the inner details. And then do the same process. After this, select all the shapes and increase their opacity. Draw a shape to fill up the empty space and arrange it to back. Next, select the shape and apply this faded dark color using the color code hash 716D61. Next, we're going to be creating this metal plating over the gap. To create this, we'll be using vector resources. We'll be using this Viking shoulder vector. Open it in Illustrator. Ungroup it and select the required shapes. Then drag and drop it to our main document. Select the horizontal shape and place it over our design. Scale on the size and place it just above the forehead. Now go to Object, Envelope Distort and apply Make with Mesh. Give 1x2 rows and column. Then using the Die Selection tool, edit the anchor points and the handles to match it with the perspective view of the head. After that, expand the shape. Delete out this stretched oval and create a duplicate of this smaller ovals to fill up the empty space. Adjust the size and the position to give a proper proportion. Now select all the circles and apply bright yellow color. Then select the lower base and apply dark faded color. Next, drag in our second shape and place it in the middle. Apply Make with Mesh with 2x1 rows and column. Then, using the Die Selection tool, start adjusting the anchor points. Adjust the handles to give the curve flow. Try to maintain the shape of the cap. Set the angles according to the base design. Give it a little thickness and drag down the lower ends until it reaches the nose. Once you are done with the adjustments, expand the shape and apply the same dark faded color. Now create a duplicate of the circle and arrange it to front. Create a multiple number of copies of this circle and place it along the metal plate. As it goes upward, the size and the width also changes. Next, create a duplicate of the top shape and apply dark color. Then arrange it to back. Drag it down and sideways. This shape will be used to represent the thickness of the metal shape. Let's create under duplicate of the shape and apply this faded color. To reduce the amount of anchor points, go to Object, Path, Simplify. Here, set the threshold to full and curve precision to around 65%. After that, edit the anchor points and arrange it to back. Lastly, we'll do some final adjustments with the design. Adjust the handles and the points to set the curve path. Also, to remove the visible edges, select the base shape and increase the stroke thickness. Then go to Object, Path, Outline Stroke. After that, click on minus front option on the Pathfinder. This will remove the extended edges. Next, we'll apply this design to a t-shirt mockup. So open a new document. Set the dimension 2000 by 1200 pixels. Now, we'll drag in the t-shirt mockup to our main document. You can find different type of t-shirt mockup from the internet which you can download and reuse. Scale down the size and fit it according to our document. To apply our design to your t-shirt, double click on the smart object. Here, drag in our vector design and place it around here. Then save the file. It will be updated in our main file. Let's increase the size and again save it. Now to change the color of the t-shirt, double click on the color smart layer. Then using the color picker tool, pick the color from the design, then click OK. Next, add a background color. Use the color code #657A7B. Now, we'll tweak the t-shirt. So press Command or Control T to activate the transform option and scale up the size. Now right click and choose distort and start tweaking the corner points. We're going to give a perspective view to your design. Keep on adjusting the corner points. Once you are done with the adjustments, press enter. Next, we'll do some color correction. So add a hue and saturation adjustment layer. Increase the saturation value to increase the color intensity. Then brightness and contrast adjustment layer to increase the contrast. Lastly, type our text Viking design. Give it a white color. We'll use the font Latin Guy DC heavy font. Adjust the size and the position. And finally, we have completed creating Viking avatar t-shirt design using Illustrator and Photoshop. During the process, we have used some new tools and the vector resources to speed up our workflow. I hope you enjoy the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.